What's up, YouTube? This is Christopher Mavros coming to you from Athens, Greece. Today, I'm going to show you how to create an AI assistant for your Joomla website in a few minutes for free. First, we need to download the free ChatGPT assistant module from mavroschristophoros.com or mavxr.com for short. You can find the link in the description. Don't forget to subscribe for the release of our amazing upcoming component ChatGPT Assistant Pro, which trains a custom GPT with your Joomla content, allowing your customers to receive highly specific, professional support about your website, all done with only a few clicks. In order to install ChatGPT Assistant, visit your Joomla backend, go to System, Install Extensions, and upload the file you downloaded. Once installed, you can find the module in Content, Side Modules, so that you can configure it. The first thing you need to do is to place your OpenAI API key. To obtain a key, go to platform.openai.com/api-keys, which may change in the future, and create a new secret key. Please don't use this key, as I'm going to delete it right after making this video. ChatGPT Assistant does not leak your keys. They are 100% secure in your Joomla backend. Place this key in your newly created module and make sure to set the module to a template position that is visible in the frontend so that it shows up. Also, publish it and set it to appear in all pages. Let's see what we've done so far. So, as you can see, we now have a working ChatGPT assistant in our Joomla website. However, this assistant will respond to any user query, regardless of whether it's relevant to our website or not. We are going to change that in a minute. Let's get back to our module options and see what we've got there. Below the OpenAI API key, there's a hard chat limit that you can set to limit the amount of messages sent to ChatGPT from your website per session. Let's move on to the Module Options tab. As you can see, there's a bunch of options to tweak here in order to get your assistant to respond exactly like you want it to. Let's get started with the initial model instruction. This option allows you to instruct the model and tell it what you want it to be. The more information you put here, the better the results will be. However, keep in mind that this instruction is included in every request that is made to the model, so adding too much information may result in a higher cost. Make sure that you understand the costs and set a hard limit for charges in your OpenAI account settings. Structuring your initial model instruction is important and requires a little bit of prompt engineering. I won't cover every aspect of prompt engineering in this video, but let me explain a few basic things. Let's assume for the sake of this example that our website is an educational platform where students require assistance to select a course. We could structure our initial instruction like this. You are a helpful assistant for an online educational platform offering courses in various subjects. Your role is to assist students with course selection and offer study tips. Let's tell it how to respond. Your responses must be professional, educational, and supportive. Decline any irrelevant information. Send users to our contact form if they require more information. Now let's provide some context information. Our list of courses include math, calculus, geometry, physics, science, rocket science. Let's try it out. Go to the front end, find the module, open the interface and ask it any question. How to groom your pet? As you see, the response now is very cool. What about help me select a course? As you see, the information provided is relevant and helpful. Of course, the system message can be tweaked more and more until the responses match our needs. Before closing this video, let's take a look at a couple more options like the response max tokens, the temperature, and the message formats. Changing the response max tokens will allow the model to produce longer responses and avoid cutoffs. Setting it to anywhere between 100 and 300 is fine. The temperature option controls whether you want the model to take risks or not. Lowering the temperature near zero will provide more stable answers, while increasing it near one will make it more creative in cases that something like that is desirable. The user message format and assistant response format options allow you to style the messages, wrapping them around text if needed. Finally, the limit rich system instruction tells the model that there's only one more answer left before closing the conversation, so that the model's last message has a tone of closure. I would love to learn what you make with ChatGPT Assistant, so don't hesitate to post your ideas in the comment section. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. Once again, this has been Christopher Mavros from mavrosstoffers.com. Thanks for watching!